RCEP as and with the ASEAN countries as a huge block within the RCEP would impact about 50% of the world's population, and unfortunately, 50 this much or many peoples do not have a real say on the status of the negotiations, the status of the dealings and wheelings within the RCEP. In a regime where women's and people's rights are most often subsumed by the interests of corporations, unfortunately, women's and people's rights are sacrificed at the altar of free trade agreements such as the RCEP.
One of the chapters in RCEP is water services, and to have this chapter means that that every country that become the member of RCEP have to open their services to a foreign country or other member of the RCEP countries to having investment or even to provide and to doing the services in our countries. So it will really cost a lot in our country, especially in the Southeast Asia region. We know that there are several countries that also still struggle to fulfill the right to health for the people.
So most LDCs, because they do not have production capacity, they import. So at the moment you are not able to produce a lot of stuff, you will import, you will keep your importing fees low. Problem is, in the FTAs it's all getting tight because no country can raise duties. So even if it's in the exemption list, you cannot increase duties. You freeze it at 5.1%. So I think in terms of policy space for industrialization, the LDCs really need to worry because they have no duties. And if they will now freeze it under RCEP, how will they industrialize? They can never develop these products again because they will become dependent on imports before they have the ability to develop it.
One of the big concerns we have is obviously how it's going to impact labor and workers in the region. And we feel that many provisions, many aspects of what is there in the proposal for an RCEP are going to impact employment. Either because there are going to be more imports because of lower tariffs that will lead to job losses, or because by losing certain policy tools, again, tariff itself is a policy tool, but also through having constraints on the kind of request one can make on investment when there are foreign direct investment coming. These will have an impact also on the ability to create employment in the future. So these are very valid concerns in a context where there is a crisis of employment in many of the countries in the region.
actually to protect the Indian agriculture, we have only one main tool, which is tariff. That has already been slashed to zero level in the India-ASEAN Free Trade Agreement. But here, it is not just trade agreement. It is also an agreement which is talking about investments. We are already facing a lot of problems in the investments. For example, Tirumala Milk, one of the South India's largest private dairy, has been acquired by Lactalis of French company, which has created a price war within the country with cooperatives.
From WTO, we have been saying agriculture out of WTO. Agriculture is life. Agriculture is food. Food cannot be traded. Food is life for us. And the other thing is RCEP. We are also not accepting RCEP because it's suicidal. How many farmers in India? More than 300,000 within 10 in a decade. Committed suicide. Tamil Nadu within a month's time 200, and it is going on increasing. It's all the agreements, more and more pesticide use, more and more the cost of investment to produce, and they are not getting minimum support price from the government, and there is so much of debt cancellation. These are the two points that our farmers are fighting. The government is not listening. So for us as women farmers, we are saying we don't believe in all these agreements. It is not working towards us. We don't want them.
Well, we engage in this sort of shadowing the negotiations occasionally. But I think the real battle happens at the national and local levels. And the different constituencies here would have to go back to their own campaigns at national and local levels to share the information that we get, continue the education work that is, I think, very important in order to build a stronger movement.